For the entrance hymn, we shall take A124, wherever two or three.
Wherever two or three are gathered in my name, I will be with you, the Lord proclaim. Come, brothers, come, sisters, gather round the Lord. Come, brothers, come, sisters, hear His holy word, and He will give us happiness, He will bring us peace. His goodness is eternal and His wonders never cease. Wherever two or three are gathered in my name, I will be with you, the Lord proclaim.
My dear brothers and sisters, we offer this Mass for the soul of José Esteban Saldaña. This Mass is given by Arnold and his family. Let us ask for God's mercy and ask God to bless José with heaven. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, from the day of our baptism, we have been sharers in the triple mission of Christ: prophetic, priestly, and kingly mission. Today's liturgy brings to our focus the prophetic mission. God has chosen us to be prophets, and also God wants us to accept the message that is sent by Him through others as prophets. For He has chosen us before the foundation of the world to be blameless, to be spotless, to be in love with Him, to continuously live in His presence. So God's purpose of our creation is He wants us to be with Him forever. Let us thank God for the gift of our faith. Thank God for His love, and also ask for pardon for many times we have not heard His message. We have neglected the prophets that God has sent to us. We have refused to accept them and their message. Let us ask for His pardon. Let us all together say, I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy on us all. Christ have mercy, Christ have mercy, Christ have mercy on us all. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy on us all. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy on us all.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Let us pray. Please bring to mind your intention. O God, who show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path, give all who, for the faith they profess, are accounted Christians, the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the prophet Amos. In those days, Amaziah, the priest of Bethel, said to Amos, O seer, go, flee away to the land of Judah, and eat bread there, and prophesy there. But never again prophesy at Bethel, for it is the king's sanctuary, and it is the temple of the kingdom. Then Amos answered and said to Amaziah, I was no prophet, nor a prophet's son, but I was a herdsman and a dresser of sycamore figs. But the Lord took me from following the flock, and the Lord said to me, Go, prophesy to my people Israel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsible Psalm. Let us see, O Lord, your mercy and grant us your salvation. Please repeat.
Let us see,
O Lord, your mercy and grant us your salvation. I will hear what the Lord God speaks. He speaks of peace for his people and his faithful. His salvation is near for those who fear him, and his glory will dwell in our land. Response.
Let us see, O Lord, your mercy,
and grant us your salvation. Merciful Lord, love and faithfulness have met. Justice and peace have kissed. Faithfulness shall spring from the earth, and justice look down from heaven. repeat.
Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation.
Also the Lord will bestow his bounty, and our earth shall yield its increase. Justice will march before him and guide his steps on the way. Response.
Let us see, O Lord, your mercy, and grant us your salvation. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places, even as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before him. In love, he predestined us for adoption to himself as sons through Jesus Christ, according to the purpose of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace, with which he has blessed us in the Beloved. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of his grace, which he lavished upon us in all wisdom and insight, making known to us the mystery of his will, according to his purpose, which he set forth in Christ as a plan for the fullness of time, to unite all things in him, things in heaven and things on earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel acclamation.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
May the God of our Lord Jesus Christ enlighten the eyes of our hearts, that we may know what is the hope to which he has called us.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus called the 12 and began to send them out two by two and gave them authority over the unclean spirits. He charged them to take nothing for their journey except a staff. No bread, no bag, no money in their belts, but to wear sandals and not put on two tunics. And he said to them, whenever you enter a house, stay there until you depart from there. And if any place will not receive you and they will not listen to you, when you leave, shake off the dust that is on your feet as a testimony against them. So they went out and proclaimed that people should repent, and they cast out many demons and anointed with oil many who were sick and healed them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear friends, as we have been reminded in the introduction, we share in the triple ministry mission of Christ. And one of the missions is prophetic mission. In the first reading, we have heard God sending Amos to Israel to prophesy in his name the news that God wants them to give. And the news is that Israelites have to mend their ways. To understand the message of Amos, it is important to understand the context in which Israelites were living. We know that after the death of Solomon, Israel's kingdom was divided into two kingdoms: the kingdom of Judah and the kingdom of Israel. The kingdom of Judah had its capital at Jerusalem, and Israel had Samaria as its capital. Only two tribes were faithful to Rehoboam, the son of Solomon. The remaining 10 tribes got together and they formed their own kingdom. So Judah, Jerusalem, the southern kingdom with two tribes, Israel, northern kingdom with 10 tribes. Initially, people from both the kingdoms used to come to Jerusalem to worship God. But the king of Israel feared that his subjects, when they go to Jerusalem to worship God, they may remain there and show their allegiance to the king there. And he was feared of losing his throne. So therefore, he builds another temple in his kingdom at the place called Bethel. This place is very famous. We know about this place. When Abraham reached where was given the promised land, at Bethel he worshipped God. That we find in Genesis. Then you see also Jacob, after running away from his brother Esau, you know about the dream at Bethel that he had. So he also worships there. So Bethel is a holy place, God's house. And therefore, now when Amos from Judah went to Israel, Amaziah, the priest of the king Jeroboam, he tells him, go to your land, don't come here. You are a foreigner. And time and again they had fights. You don't come and preach here. Whatever good news, so-called good news according to you, don't come and preach here. You go to your land and preach. So Amos' message is not accepted there. They also had a king, the priests were maintained by the king. And therefore, these priests, they had a soft corner for the king because their expenditure was maintained by him. There were also other people around who were called so-called prophets. They were false prophets like fortune tellers. They would go on begging, telling the people that in the name of God, we are telling you this. Actually, they were false prophets. So Amaziah also thinks that Amos is one of those. And therefore he says, don't speak on name of God. And the task for Amos was difficult, first of all, because he was a foreigner. And second, because whatever message that he wanted to give was not reliable for the people of Israelites at that time, because they were living a prosperous life. When they were having happy life, prosperous life, then a prophet of doom is not accepted. Message of calamity is not accepted, because what Amos would tell him, he would tell him Jeroboam would die by the sword and Israelites would be led to exile. So this was the message he was giving. What they had to do is repent, come back to God. They were not ready to accept the message. In the gospel we have heard, Jesus also sends his apostles as prophets, as bearers of the good news. The first thing they are told to do is announce the kingdom of God. In Mark chapter 1 verse 15, when Jesus begins his public ministry, he begins with these words, repent and believe in the gospel. The kingdom of God is near. So the kingdom of God has already come. Proclaim that kingdom. And therefore, to accept that kingdom of God, the reign of God, Jesus himself, you need to repent. So that is the good news that he wants his prophets to proclaim. Secondly, he tells them, do not rely on human power, human wealth, but trust in God's providence. Jesus knew that there is a possibility of humans being greedy for money, and that can spoil the mission. And therefore he cautions them, do not rely on your wealth, your power, on yourself. Trust in God and rely on his power. And third, he tells them, you must have preferential love for the sick. So those who were possessed with demons and other infirmities, people were sick with different types of disease, the mission was given to them to anoint them, to heal them. That was the mission. So you see here, the prophet's role is to represent God to people, to bring them the good news. And if there is something that is unbefitting of a follower of God, of a believer of God, then the prophet is supposed to challenge that. Jeremiah chapter 1 verses 9 to 10 we get. The words God tells, you are going to speak, I will put in your mouth. So you are not going to speak your words. I have chosen you as a prophet over nations and kingdoms. So you are going to proclaim, use only words which I give you. And what is your role? Your role is to uproot what is evil, to plant what is good, to destroy what is evil, to build what is good. So that's why God sends his prophets. The only concern of God is God does not want to lose us. God wants us to be saved because he loves us very much. He does not intend the death of a sinner, but his life. And that is what we have heard in the second reading today. Before the foundation of the world, God chose us to be holy and blameless, to live in his presence through love. Ephesians chapter 1 verse 4. So if God's dream is that we are predestined to be in communion with him forever, we need to respond to this God's love in a positive way. First of all, by listening to the prophets that are around us, maybe our own family members, maybe our friends, maybe our church authorities. The messenger could come from anywhere. That does not matter. Amaziah, the priest, would tell Amos, go to your land and preach that, not here. So Amos's message was not accepted, neither he was accepted. When we drink water from the tap, we are not bothered about whether the tap is made of metal or plastic. The shape of the tap does not matter to us. What matters to us is the water. It should be clean and pure. So when God sends a prophet to mend our ways, what matters is not the person who gives the message, the content of the message. This message comes from God. God is the sender. And therefore, if anyone challenges our evil ways, suppose my own children challenge me, God can speak through them, so they become prophets. If my husband corrects me, if my wife tells me something, this is not okay, come to pray, or something is not okay with my life, somebody brings to my focus, that is the messenger of God. And today's liturgy tells us, listen. Listen. Only when we listen to these messages, we'll be able to run to God and to be part of that kingdom which God wants us to possess. Secondly, God has called each one of us to be prophets. Prophets representing God, to speak in His name, not to speak what I want to speak, but to speak what God wants to speak. So therefore, prophets everywhere, in our family, in our society, at our workplace, everywhere we need to represent God. And thirdly, if God has chosen us to be with Him, let us acknowledge all the limitations that we have, the weaknesses that we have. We are happy, everything goes well, and some message comes like that, as it came to King Jeroboam and his people, the message of calamity. They tell us, if you don't change something, something bad will happen, the consequence will be bad. So for knowingly, when we do something evil, then it becomes grave. So it is important for all of us to acknowledge our limitations, our weaknesses, every day, to evaluate our lives, to examine our lives. So we become prophets to ourselves, so that we remain blameless and holy before God. May God in this Eucharistic celebration help us to do the same. Please stand. Let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Amen. Let's put forth some of our petitions before the Lord.
For the Church, that she may be faithful to the mission to which the Lord has called her. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, that its governments may serve its people in justice and truth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For us, that we may cherish the fact that through no merits of our own, God has blessed us with His sons and daughters in Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For us, that as we continue the mission of Jesus, we may remember that the message, the mission, then the means to accomplish it are His. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are terminally ill, that our Christian love may never fail them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us place before God our personal prayers. Abba, Father, we have placed before You some of our petitions. Grant us what we have asked for, if it is Your will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. For the offertory, we shall take the hymn B23, Lord, accept this bread and wine.
Accept this bread and wine. Take our hearts and make them.
take our world and our anxiety. Give us life and liberty. Change this bread into your body and this wine into your blood. Change our lives, make us united, Lord, to spread the love of Christ the Lord.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look upon the offerings of the church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
the mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Philip Neri, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Spiritual Communion Prayer. By Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into myself. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
For the communion hymn, we shall take D67, Lord, you are my everything.
Let us pray. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth. The Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
For the recessional hymn, we shall take S19, God's Spirit is in my heart.
God's Spirit is in my heart. He has called me and set me apart. This is what I have to do, what I have
sent me to give the good news to the poor. Tell prisoners that they are prisoners no more. Tell blind people that they can see. And set the downtrodden free. And go tell everyone the news that the kingdom of God has come. And go tell everyone the news that God's kingdom has come.